Here are 5 must-know things about Hostinger that I wish somebody told me before I started using their services. And trust me, this info you won't get anywhere else. The price you see on their website doesn't accurately represent how much you'll be paying if you continuously use Hostinger. It's just an introductory price and it applies to your first term only. For example, if you buy the cheapest plan for 48 months, you'll pay a one-time subscription fee of around $95. However, after the 4-year period is over, you'll have to pay $191 if you want to continue using the service, because the renewal fee is no longer $1.99, it's actually $3.99. You could say, what the fuck, how is this even legal and how can they get away with this? But the sad truth is that, yeah, it is legal and almost every single web hosting company I know is using this tactic. It's almost like an unspoken rule of web hosting at this point. On the bright side, Hostinger price increase isn't as bad as most other popular companies in the space. Hostinger is still on average at least 2 times cheaper than Bluehost or GoDaddy and 4 times cheaper than SiteGround. It's also important to keep in mind that you won't actually be paying monthly. You must pay for the whole period upfront. So if you're buying for 4 years, you'll be paying for 4 years upfront at checkout. But you could get a sweet 10% off by using the link in the description and typing in the code Emit.Reviews to save yourself some money. This is the biggest discount available online, but I do want to inform you that this is an affiliate link. If you use it, I'll make a commission, but this is basically how I monetize my channel and can create videos as a full-time job. You making purchases using these links is always appreciated, but never expected of. What is expected though is that your website won't crash as soon as you get your first visitor. So that's why I've done a little research to see just how many users these cheap Hostinger plans can handle. The cheapest Hostinger plan comes with 1 CPU core and 768 MB of RAM, the premium one is 1 CPU core and 1024 MB of RAM, and the business plan comes with 2 CPU cores and 1536 MB of RAM.
Huh?
I know, these numbers probably mean very little to you, so let me explain. Every time a user comes to your website, he takes up some RAM. You run out of RAM, your website crashes. In my experience, around 7 MB of RAM are needed for one user, so in theory, if you have the cheapest plan, you can have around 110 users on at the same time, with the premium plan it's around 145 users, and with the business plan it's around 220 users at the same time. Users at the same time is not the same thing as overall users, because if only 100 people can visit your site at the same time, thousands of people can still access it throughout the month. So buy your plans accordingly and buy them for the longest possible period, because historically, Hostinger prices have only been going up. So if you buy for a longer period of time, you sort of lock in that better price. And for me personally, I like their services enough to put faith in them to buy for a longer period of time. Honestly, if you're just creating one website, there's not much reason to buy the premium plan, because the resources you get are almost the same as the cheapest plan. However, there is another thing you must think about first. E-commerce stores, blogs, portfolio websites, small business websites, resumes, all have different needs. For example, e-commerce stores often need additional plugins for custom functionality. That's going to take up more CPU power. So would I host an e-commerce store on Hostinger? No, probably not, because there are better options available like Nexus. Check out my video about them right here, where you can get like hundreds of dollars worth of plugins bundled into your e-commerce plan for a smoother experience. Hostinger plans work best for websites that you need to set up fast and easy, because the interface is incredibly easy to use compared to most other web hosting providers. You have everything in one place, so you don't need to buy things from different websites, and you can create a professional site within like 20 minutes. All of the technical aspects are fully automated, so you only need to worry about the texts, images, or the layout of your website. I actually have a tutorial on how to set up your website using Hostinger the right way that you can find by clicking here. So if you do decide to buy a plan with them, I highly recommend following this guide. Remember when I talked about resources? Well, there are times when your website gets a spike of visitors that you weren't planning on. For e-commerce, this usually happens during Christmas or Black Friday shopping, and Hostinger has a really neat feature to help you out here. Once a month, for 24 hours, you can significantly boost your website's performance. I'm talking like 2 or 3 times here. So if you're going for a job interview, or you know that an important client is going to be visiting your site that day, or you're bringing traffic to your site via additional ads, take advantage of that boost completely free of charge.
I'm going into boost mode, boys.
I develop websites for people and I hate when I get a random call at a random time with a person being like,
"Yeah, so I tried changing some stuff around myself, now everything is broken. Can you fix it, please?"
That's why I always tell people you need to have two websites. One is for the clients, called the live version, and one is for messing around, testing features and updates, called the test version. You do everything on the test version, and if it works, you merge it into the live version. Most of the time, beginner users don't even think about this, and seasoned users, well, for them it just seems like it's too much work, because you have to buy two separate website names, you need to host two separate websites, then you need to do all the merging stuff. It's like just too much work. Blech. However, if you got the Hostinger business plan, you get access to what's called a staging environment. Hostinger will clone your website automatically and you won't even need a separate name because they'll use a subdomain, and you can make changes on the test site, and once you're ready, just hit publish, they'll automatically transfer the changes to your live site. Now that you know this information, I highly recommend you check out this video next, where I showcase how to properly set up your Hostinger website completely from scratch. It will solve so many issues for you down the line, it's not even funny. Anyways, congratulations on starting your website journey. My name is Emit, and I'll see you in the next video.